We're going to do a birdhouse. We're going to zhuzh it up. We're going to put snowflakes on it. We're going to make a pretty bow. Right. I'm going to start out with some white paint. And I'm just going to go ahead and start getting this done. And then on the top, we're going to kind of do a weathered look. Okay, so these are the colors that we have. And I'm just going to kind of start with a little bit of the brown, and I'm just gonna kinda almost dry brush it. Sometimes this turns out really good, and sometimes I have to kinda work at it. I've done only two of these, so hopefully we'll get a good coat on here. All right, then I'm gonna add just a touch of black kinda through there. I'll turn it around so y'all can kinda see what I'm doing. Okay, go to the other side. We'll paint the base of this black. Just want it to look weathered, like it's old. Now we're gonna do a touch of gray. Kind of try to make it look like old barn wood. We'll let that kind of, I noticed the last time that I tried this, I didn't let each layer dry, and it kind of made it all meld together, so I want to give that other side a little bit of chance to dry a little bit. Now, I'm going to go across the bottom, though, and we're going to paint this black as a platform. All right, I am going to hit this just for a second with the blow dryer. Hey y'all, what do you think? Does it look pretty like old farm wood? I'm gonna lay this down, and I think I'm gonna go ahead and put on some of our snowflakes, because y'all will see what I mean here in a minute, why I wouldn't put them on after I get it done. So we've got this kind here. This is in the rose gold, very pretty. And then we've got this kind. It kind of takes on a Celtic feel to me. And it's in the silver. So I've got two of each. I think I want to put, I'm gonna probably put these on the front and maybe a couple on the sides. That's pretty. Let's see? Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna make a wintry scene, but I may throw a little bit of red in here just because you can't ever, you know, red's fine. In the summer, it pops. So I'm going to come over on this side, and I'm going to affix a little bit of this floral oasis that I like. I tend to use this because it's easier for me to deal with than regular foam or styrofoam. I may have that too thick, but we're gonna see. I'm just gonna hold this on here for a minute. Now, what I've got some of this that I kind of spread open so that I can get to pieces easier. And then I've got this really pretty faux mistletoe. That looks wintry, doesn't it? So let's see what I wanna use first. I'll just kind of go with my gut and start building. I never know. Okay, I'm going to just put this in here kind of wild. It's gonna be a big arrangement. There. I'm gonna keep turning around so y'all can see what I'm doing. I'm just sticking it in the oasis. You can use glue if you want to. I've not ever really had a problem with anything coming out. Let's see, where am I gonna add this? He's kind of big, isn't he? I don't think we're gonna use that whole thing. Let's just use pieces. I wish my sister were here. I'd tell her to go turn that heater down. Can y'all hear it? It's just blowing up a storm. Whew, right above me. let me turn this back around so y'all can kind of see. I'm just adding pieces wherever I feel like they need to go. I don't ever have a strategy. Okay, so this is what we have so far. I know it doesn't look like much yet, but we're gonna add some pine cones. I've got these little ones. I've got this one long one. I love these. I don't know. I'm going to put this right there and we're gonna hold it. Let me do that over. The thing with the faux stuff is you can stick and glue and do whatever you want. And people that do the real florals, that's hard. Now, we're gonna take this. This is my favorite. I used this last week with the silver. We're gonna use some of it, and I thought about, I may be changing my mind though. I thought about using the buffalo plaid with it to give it a little bit of, have that black come out. I may go ahead and do that. So let me use this first. See how big I want my bow. I usually get those too big too. I think that'll be great. Always have a good pair of scissors. And like I said, with this, you don't even have to worry about doing a knife edge or anything like that. Move this out of the way. Tie this off. Right before where I do things out of order. And then it's hard to go back. So let me see. Put this one. That'll be good. And then this one, I will do a pretty black dovetail. And I just tie it off with the twine. That's easier for me. And we'll try to add another piece of bling to this bow. Okay, I'm just gonna tie this onto the other one. That's the way I stack them. And then we can cut all that away since I'm gonna just be gluing it. Okay. You wouldn't think that these two things would go together, but they do. I've used them several times, actually, together. Okay. I get all these too big, and then I have to figure out how I'm gonna get it all in there. Okay, now, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna try something. I've really been liking these floral picks lately. And you can just cut them down if it's too deep, too long. I'm gonna put this through here. Cause usually I just glue them. But sometimes it's better if you can use a pick or a stake, whatever those are called. You can tell I don't know all the technical names for floral design. Now I could back that up. Let me turn it around. Before I stake it in, I am gonna add a little bit of glue. That'll just give it extra, kind of something to help hold it. A pretty bling here. Okay, this right here, look at this. This is part of the rhinestone collection. Isn't it beautiful? We're gonna put that in the middle of that bow. Handy on my bows. Okay, y'all, so we've got this. Now, I'm gonna cut this away a little bit. And we're gonna add some more greenery to this backside. Y'all see how y'all can see that styrofoam? Now, let me see. I just thought we'd give it a little bit of color. Actually, that's gonna work real well right there, I think, against that plaid. all we've got to do is tip our beautiful greenery there. Let me get another plate because I went to put stuff in the other one. And I'm not going to need much because we're going to just tip it a little bit. I know that bling stands out, doesn't it? I'm glad y'all like this. Even with our little red bird, you're all ready for winter.
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.